Greetings everyone, Alex Alien Nerd here, and today we are playing the remake of an old school classic. Is this gonna happen every time? I've had a lot of technical difficulties trying to get this thing to work. But, yeah, if you guys didn't know, Panzer Dragoon was a game on the Sega Saturn in 95. So... yeah, it was ostensibly like a launch title to be like, oh my god, this is the new cutting edge console. And it honestly, if you ask me, it honestly led to a pretty good series of video games, despite the Saturn being what it was. And they remade it not too long ago, and which is what I'm playing now. The whole thing was a port that was ported on the Xbox with Panzer Dragoon Orta, which can still be played on modern Xbox consoles today, and if you have one, I would definitely recommend doing it. Because Orta's a really great game. It improves upon this one in every single way. But the reason as to why I'm showing you this cutscene in its entirety is that this is a rail shooter, but it ostensibly has no story after this first cutscene, aside from a chase. So I thought, okay, I'll just play this out in its entirety and just show you everything. Because from an art design and world building perspective, this looks great on both versions of the game. And the team that made these games, I don't know whether it's Forever Entertainment or Megapixel, they did the House of the Dead remake, but they were also asked to do Zwei, which I've played on an emulator, and I'm just anxiously waiting for that, because much like how Order is a great sequel to this, so Zwei. Like, I think Team Andromeda, though, is an incredibly underrated team for, like, they just squeeze so much into world building and that into what's ostensibly a pretty brainless genre. They also made an anime adaptation of this, the first one, but honestly, it's really bad. I think I might talk about it in another video, but... I also have a copy of Panzer Dragoon Saga, which is one of those things that my brother was just like completely insane for, being like, yeah, okay, I'll give him a legit version of this instead of an emulator. I don't even have a Saturn, so it's just sitting in a safe. I mean, I appreciate it, but good Christ, he's bad at financials if he does that. I know this piece of music comes back in like a... In one of the Sega Sports games. Like one of the sports licensed Sonic games. But... I definitely think that it's like one of the best... better soundtracks in video games back then. Like, and when I say back then, I mean 95. Oh god, the... You know, I was about to reveal what, like, this... What the gimmick of this game is that truly set it apart from Star Fox, which... was one of Sega's concerns in development about this game. That it was like, we really need to like show this off to be an actual 3D game instead of doing tricks like Star Fox, F-Zero, or Doom. And there was an opportunity. Ostensibly, at the top right, there's a radar, and you're supposed to keep an eye on both what you're doing and the radar. Like, the graphics of the first one haven't aged all that well, as you probably might surmise, but it's like, it's still 95, and for the time, I'll defend the graphics. Still, this is fun. It's like just Star Fox on an armored blue dragon. An adorable blue dragon. Did they just shoot something? Yeah, they did. I avoided them. I'm not exactly an expert at this game, but... it's like I came to this party extremely late, but... when it did come, I personally prefer Zwei, Order, and Saga to the first one. Boss fight. Most of the... And yeah, most of it, these battles really do just amount to hold A and wave the thumbstick around. And the thing is that the reason why I'm playing it like this and not on... and not how it was on order, because sometimes I do that. Like, I don't bother to do texture mods or graphics mods or shit like that. It's basically because it's way easier on here than it is in the original. And, like, the original is one of those... Like, one of the pet peeves I have with the original is... That this is me picking on the genre of a rail shooter or it being a rail shooter, but it's honestly like, okay, it gives you like 6 tries, I think. And if you fail them, which is easy to do when you're on normal or high difficulty, which is the only way to finish the game. Aim in the original version. Basically, it leads. It's just way too hardcore, and it's like, okay, it just artificially inflates and all the length of an already difficult game. So that's like my. So that's what ultimately has me prefer this version over the original. Even if that is, like, sacrilege among the fan base of the game. Oh, and by the way, one aspect of the world building for the first two games, and I think order, I'm not sure if it's in order, but... is the language. It's not Japanese they're speaking, it's Panzerese, a language that they constructed specifically for these games. And... The Sand. This almost feels overpowered. But at the same time, too, it's like... it's like I'm flying a dragon. You want this to feel cool. But at the same time, if people aren't really a fan of it, I can see why. I know what's coming. This is the first fight with the Dark Dragon. Oh, no it's not. Right, come on. Yeah, here we go. I think I got it. Okay. Got that. I actually managed to shoot it down. At least... oh, there's another one. I don't think I've ever done a 100% shoot down of that and not got a tinsy bit hurt. On a honestly, I prefer the roar that the dragon has in Saga and Order. Time to destroy weapons of war. I don't know what I'm targeting there, but I think I just clipped through reality. God, well, at least someone hit me now. Other thing that I'm going to say, yeah, this is an improvement over the original, is that there are like these, cutscenes to introduce the bosses, that they kind of give it a more of a weight. But nevertheless, I get proved right in doing it. And phase two. God, they come back. Yeah, it's been a while since I've played these games. I just remember, like, one of the bosses in Order being extraordinarily difficult. Yeah, I'm not falling for that again. Come on. There we go. Ah, this one. This is pretty long and winding. Like, for a first-time player, you really wouldn't know where to go. Well, where you're gonna go, considering you have no freedom over where you're going. Yeah, this game gets really frantic. I mean, like, I get it, it's a rail shooter, but good Christ, this is... Okay. And if I recall rightly, this is where the boss is. Yeah. Yep. Yeah, this thing is immune to your dragon blast, so you have to shoot it. Shoot it with your gun. Sure that there are old school Sega fans basically screaming at me for this. Coming, even though it's telegraphed to me, with the absolute wrong option. Yeah, if I survive this one, I'm going to be amazed. I thought it was immune to the Dragon Blast. It is now. God. Damn it! Why? Like, Orta, at least, stop, at least, has, like, a continue system where you go back to the boss. Okay, fine. Okay. Okay, cool. All you gotta do is just hold A and wait for them to drop from the ground, up from the ceiling when you know they're there. Okay, I'm back at the boss, and if I choose to include that in the video, then yeah, I'm happy with starting it like that. Yeah, I know it's not gonna work, but who cares? Come on. Get the life bar. Get the life bar. Yeah, sorry, that got really disorienting and I really didn't mean it. This is gonna be a... Yeah, it hurt me. Sometimes they just throw you like a barrage of projectiles and stuff right at ya. And even then, while I did admit this game was easier, I never said that it was... I never said that you wouldn't die full stop if you didn't know what you were doing. And I proudly admit that I do not know what I'm doing. Thank you. So it turns out that there is something that was dragon proof. That was dragon proof, but nevertheless, it still gets destroyed all the same. Cool. It was getting a little awkward there. You again. Why are my eyes like that? Yeah, continuing on from that, I really would not have known you were there if you just didn't. You didn't attempt to try to kill me. remember this boss. Right, I'm actually surprised I got through that. There's no health bar. Have to have multiple forms. Didn't mean to press that. Okay, come on. Yeah, okay. Now, I'm surprised I survived that. As I was saying, the language spoken in this game is Panzerese, which you'd think, which it's like, from the looks of it, it was just like a, like constructed from a bunch of different languages in English, but most of it has no use outside of this, so if you want to learn a language like Klingon or something, then this is not where to get it from. Yeah, if I remember this one rightly, this is a... Yeah, this is gonna be hell. Bridge. Okay. These enemies are also not exactly just random nobodies. This world that I was trying to do in a bunch of preemptive recordings to this, which resulted in technical difficulties, was that this is all set well after the apocalypse. Like, think Fallout, but way more different and imaginative weapons than nukes. And also potentially way more destructive. And so this is set like thousands of years later when dragons managed to evolve from all this. And humanity tries to cling on to whatever it has left. But the thing is that most of this is But the thing is that most of these weapons got reclaimed by an empire. God. Okay, final boss time. Oh boy. Now this is what we're trying to stop. We're trying to stop them from activating the tower, which has the ability to wipe out entire countries. Like, the whole subplot of Panzer Dragoon Saga is that there are these people that are trying their best to destroy the weapons that humanity left, that the ancestors, these guys left. One of the things that the final bosses in these games are pretty sure are pretty notorious for is that there are multiple forms of these bosses, and as a final boss. But it's not. Yeah, just wait. I know it's. Okay. Form number two. Come on. No, you haven't. Yep. So that is Panzer Dragoon. Ostensibly, it is probably the weakest of the series, if you ask me. Like, even with the, these things. Even though I did thoroughly enjoy this, but, otherwise. Yeah, I just am really, really waiting for the remake of Zwei to come out, and I really hope that Order is one of those ones that gets looked at, because it is an amazing, because those games make this one feel like a tech demo by comparison. But as I said, this is just a fun little shooting gallery game, and yeah. Hope you enjoyed that. Please like, share, and subscribe.